the Wake Up and Live with the Art Show, the performing and cultural arts program which celebrates and showcases the diversity of the arts and performing artists in Northeast Ohio.
Hi again. We're back, this time with the whole team of, well, almost the whole team. Norma Powell is off camera, but we'll talk about her in a minute. But with a lot of our team here, Gary Webster on the end, Karen Shepherd. Here we got James McGilbray, or Young Freshy Fresh again, and I'm still Sue Johnson. We're going to spend a few minutes talking about the Wake Up and Live Actors Studio. One of the things that we'd like to do is promote and showcase our own. We use our Actor Studio and Wake Up and Live with the Arts to promote what other performing artists and the arts, and even some business and community organizations who are arts affiliated, what they're doing out there. We like to promote talent, productions, special events, services, what have you. So we're going to talk about us for a few minutes, and hopefully that will entice you to want to participate with us in our Wake Up and Live with the Arts show, or when we're reactivating our play acts, our playwriting component, and our one-act plays will be in development this summer. So there are several things, including this fly.
Vincent Price is with us this evening.
Help
Vincent
me. Price. Help me.
So anyway, we've got a lot going on at the Actors Studio. We want to share that with you, the audience. And I mentioned off camera because of all, I don't believe it, but she's shy today. Norma Powell was one of many fantastic local actors, many of them Caribou actors, and a lot of them Equity actors who just worked with Dale Shields in a special stage reading production of Amen Corner that was done as a benefit for the Rainey Institute this past Monday. And you talk about good theater and seeing the local actors, what they're able to do. That was real exciting. So that was just one exciting thing with one of our actors. Right now, I'm going to tell you a little bit about what I'm doing as the director and as an actor and a coach. And we're starting up our Master the Arts private coaching and consulting. So for actors and other performing artists, playwrights, directors who don't have the opportunity or don't like a classroom learning situation, we are providing one-on-one coaching through the work that I do and through some of our team members. So if you are a person who would like to master the art of acting, or master the art of auditioning, or master the art of playwriting, or even master the art of being an entrepreneur, or perhaps being mastering the art of motivational and public speaking, these are things that you can come to us for one-on-one coaching to help you perform out there in the artistic and the real world even better than you already are. If you'd like to find out more about our Master the Arts private coaching and consulting, please contact me at wakeup4664@aol.com. That's wakeup4664@aol.com. And this is a precursor to what will be coming up, will be in development this summer, our entire Master the Arts Academy, where we will be bringing in our local talent, filmmakers, directors, writers, so forth and so on, and also national folks who are going to come in and do workshops so that we emphasize the craft, the skill, the talent of being a performing artist, not only in this community, but those of you who aspire to go on to other communities as well. I'm always teasing you, James, about heading off to Hollywood, you and Peter Lawson Jones, because you are really involved in filmmaking. And if somebody missed the last segment, tell us briefly what your current project is with Stefan J. Davis.
Well, it's a comedy, and it's about a gentleman who has spent most of his life working menial jobs, and he has finally decided that he is going to be the person that he feels he has always been intended to be. Mm-hmm. That is, a hip-hop artist.
Okay.
Now, he's a little older than the average hip-hop artist. Mm-hmm. He's 50, you know, 60, whatever.
Whatever,
you know.
Yeah.
And it's just the fun of seeing someone pursue a dream. A lot of people around him doubting that he can do it, mm-hmm. but he's absolutely confident in his talent, and, you know, you can't tell him that he won't succeed.
And we subscribe to that.
Absolutely.
A dream is a dream, and it's not about age, sex, race, none of that stuff.
That's the beauty of it.
Economics, a dream is a dream.
That's right.
And it has no age limits. Speaking of no age limits, hi, cutie. How you doing over there?
I'm great.
Miss Karen Shepherd. And what have you been up to lately with your practicing now, practicing?
Well, I completed a trial period as a part-time spiritual leader in Massillon, Ohio, and that came to an end, and then the other person that was also involved in it, he got the position. But now I'm just guest speaking at different Unity churches, and I'm also in ministerial school studying to be a Unity minister.
Great. Nice. And since you are available for lectures and workshops and so forth, why don't you give the audience the contact information about how they could reach you if they'd like you to come in and work with them?
Okay, that's my email is k_shepherd, SHEPHERD, at sbcglobal.net, and you can also reach me at 440-227-8701. And I recently did my first wedding.
Oh, congratulations.
So I can do that.
Traditional wedding or more of a
traditional,
Unity type?
Well, yeah. It's a traditional Unity.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I enjoyed that very much. It was a lot of fun.
I'm sure.
So,
yeah.
You know, if you know anyone who is thinking about it, have them contact
me. Have them contact you. You know what I forgot? Because yours and Steven's project, how can people get in touch with you as an actor, filmmaker, and working with the Stephen J. Davis Project? How can folks reach you guys?
Well, probably the best way as far as email is to email me at jamesmctheactor at yahoo.com. jamesmctheactor at yahoo.com. That's easily the best way to get in touch with me. Don't call me.
No, don't call. And you're not too sure about email, how old it will be by the time he opens it up and reads it.
It's not my strength.
It's not your strength. Okay. Now, Gary, you have big news. You even have a prototype of your new book coming out that you talk about a labor of love and a long time coming, and it's just about here. Tell us about your Tris Speaker project.
Well, this is a shameless plug time. This book is Tris Speaker and the 1920 Indians, the 1920 World Champion Indians. The book is going to be published by McFarland and Company, and that will be in August.
Oh,
it will be published in August.
Congratulations, Gary.
You can pre-order this book now. And it's cheap at half the price, which is all I'm allowed to say. But I can give you the number. You can order this book right now, 800-253-2187. 800-253-2187. And order as many copies as you would like. Give them to your friends, your enemies, everybody you know, and people you don't know.
Okay, well, give it a little more. Why should people buy this book? What's in that book that people need to know about?
Well, here's the reason that I wrote the book. It's the fact that many Clevelanders don't know that the 1920 Indians won the world championship.
Was that the last time they ever won the world championship?
No, in fact, let me tell you this story. Everybody has heard about the 1948 Indians.
Right.
There are two magic numbers in this town sports-wise. 1964, the last time the Browns won the NFL championship. 1948, the last time the Indians won the World Series. Now, our friend Chris Otasik, who has been on this program in the past, Chris has an elementary school-aged son. And during this past school year, there was a function that parents were invited to attend. And the teacher, a young teacher like late 20s, early 30-something, had put on the blackboard a number of significant events in Cleveland history. One of them was Indians win 1948 World Series. And the teacher explained to her children, this is the only time the Indians have ever won the World Series. And Chris went to the teacher and said, that's not true. They won the World Series in 1920. To which the teacher said, I didn't know that. A lot of people don't know that. This was a remarkable team and a remarkable season. They don't deserve to be forgotten. And okay. That's why I wrote the book, so Clevelanders will know about the first Indians team, one of only two Indians teams. I mean, the team has been around for 112 years.
Okay.
They've won the World Series twice.
Twice.
Most people don't know about the first team to do it, and I wanted to tell that story.
Well, that's all excellent, right. Because Cleveland is a sports town, die-hard sports town. No matter what, we keep hanging in there. We haven't won.
And in fact, well, in fact, the thing about this coming out now, it's very, very timely, because as we're filming this, taping this, as it were, the Cleveland Indians are in first place.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
And this is a team that's scrappy. There's some kind of magical things happening with them, and it's worth getting behind this team. And reading this book maybe will inspire people to begin to really believe that this can happen again. I don't know about everyone else here, but you know, I'm seeing what's happening in Cleveland now, and it's just amazing. What I'm seeing is a renaissance that has not happened since the 20s. The growth, employment, the arts, medicine, education. People are coming to Cleveland. It's vibrant again. And it's an exciting time to be here. And this looks to me like it's something that's going to be an inspiration to all of us baseball fans. And when we finish this taping, I'll go ahead and buy my copy.
Well, thank you.
Absolutely.
I appreciate it. I'll sign it for you when
I
you get it.
That.
So now you are a published author, finally. Now, we know you as well as a playwright, and you do work with Chris Ohtasek on some crazy, wacky projects
with your video.
So what have you got going now as a playwright, or work you're doing with Chris? What's up? What else is up with you? As Mr. Freshy Fresh, young Mr. Fresh would say, what up with you, bro?
Well, as a playwright, another one of our Wake Up and Live stalwarts, Michael Laurenti.
Oh, yes.
I'm going to be meeting with Michael this coming week. About a year ago, I wrote a play. It's a parody of musicals. Because when you come right down to it, I mean, as popular as musicals are, and I realize that you have to suspend belief.
Yes.
But think about it. When was the last time you were in any public place when people suddenly started jumping on tables and singing and dancing? Which, of course, happens in a musical about 15 times in the course of 2 hours, and people think nothing of it. So I wrote a parody of musicals, but I don't know how to write music, and I might be able to write lyrics, but I definitely do not know how to write music. Michael Laurenti is a performed playwright who is also an accomplished writer of music and lyrics.
Lyrics and composition.
I sent Michael the book, and as busy as he is, literally within 2 days, I had written like 12 or 15 song titles. I sent Michael the book and the song titles. Literally within 48 hours, he had sent back to me 15 songs.
Wow.
He had written the lyrics.
Yeah, that's
we're going
amazing.
To meet this week so I can hear the music, because I have not yet heard the music, and we're going to start pitching this as soon as we have all three elements, lyrics, book, and music. And it's, in a nutshell, it is called Reunion, and it's about a guy who isn't sure he wants to attend his 10-year high school reunion.
Okay. Well, speaking of playwriting, you and Michael and Vicki and you are on the playwriting team. I don't know whether you write or not, to tell you the truth, Karen.
I know you write.
Myself, I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to Karen.
Well, Karen writes it, you know.
Yeah, because, you know, we have to change the meeting to July 14th. Read your emails. I know. But we're going to start working on our own playwriting stuff for the Actors Studio, and Michael and Vicki Williams, another one of our playwrights, is involved with Michael and doing some playwrights. So that's one of the nice things about the Actors Studio too. You notice how folks may start out coming to the Actors Studio for one reason, and then by golly, we find each other, and folks start collaborating, folks start creating new projects, folks start getting out there into the broader market to really you know, connect their work with the arts community. So with that, we are going to begin to wrap up this segment and this evening session.
We're going to wrap. That's young, little, juicy, fresh, everybody. You know, I'm just so tempted to say juicy fruit. I don't know how to say juicy fruit. It's juicy, fresh.
Yeah, the juice is what you need. You know?
But in any event, I do want to thank everybody for being our guest. Edward Banks Sr. With the Bully X Project, Stephon J. Davis, of course, with our own James, I want to say James McGillicuddy, but that's not correct.
My name is changing all over the place, isn't it?
What I do want to just mention, you're going to hear more about it, but the Wake Up and Lives Actors Studio is a nonprofit performing arts, entertainment, and education organization, and we would welcome your producing partners' contributions. And so we've run out of time about it tonight, but think about it, how you can learn about becoming a producing partner to help the Wake Up and Lives Actors Studio continue its work in the community through our performances, productions, our education, and training. And I mentioned earlier, I held this up as an example, a gift for if you become a producing partner. One of the things that James McGillbray, our Renaissance man, has done, we can create your mouse pad. We have t-shirts, but they're not on camera now.
And we have cups now.
Yes. Next time we tape, we'll have to bring a cup. So please, folks, think about, be on the lookout for more about being a producing partner to help the Wake Up and Lives Actors Studio. Think about our Master the Arts private coaching and consulting as a precursor to our Master the Arts Academy. And I'm getting the one finger sign from our illustrious Lester H. Bryant Sr.
And we know which finger it is.
That it is time to wrap. So we want to thank you and Norma, who is off screen, off camera, for joining us this evening. And generally, we say at the end of each show, be sure to
wake up and live with the arts every day.
Thanks for tuning in. Till next time.